नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू आरएच केमिस्ट्री। इन टुडेज कॉमेट की 2020 प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चंस मेटलर्जी एंड हाइड्रोजन चैप्टर आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस। इफ यू आर नॉट सीन माय ओल्ड वीडियोस सो गो थ्रू दोज वीडियोस, ऑलमोस्ट 10 वीडियोस आर ओवर ऑन दिस। सो इफ यू लाइक द कंटेंट, इफ यू आर नॉट सब्सक्राइब, प्लीज सब्सक्राइब टू द चैनल। सो एंड ऑल्सो रिमेंबर, फॉर ऑल दीज सिनॉप्सिस पार्ट आई हैव गिवन द लिंक इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स। यू कैन सी दैट। इफ यू आर नॉट डाउनलोडेड, यू कैन डाउनलोड एंड प्रिपेयर फॉर दैट। And here I have taken previous year some 10 to 12 questions from these two chapters. Yes, in this particular case, if you want to take the screenshot, you can take that. So first question here, third, fourth and fifth question you can see on the screen, right? So after this, remember fifth and second and sixth one you can see here, second and sixth one. After that, so 7, 8, 9, 10. So here you can see 7th question. 8th question completely, 10th question. So 9th question is here in this particular case, right? Now you can see that 9th question. So these are the 10 questions I am going to discuss. Yes, let us start with, yes, very simple. And this is the one question almost in the from 2015 and previous year. Remember, 3 times it was asked this question, magnetite ore is. Remember, we know that magnetite ore formula is Fe3O4. So Fe3O4 means whether it is ferrous, ferric hydroxide, ferrous or ferric oxide. This is oxide, so this is not the answer. Ferrous means Fe+2, ferric means Fe+3, right? So Fe3O4, it is having two oxide mixture, FeO and Fe2O3. Remember, FeO is having oxidation state 2, Fe2O3 is having oxidation state 3. Hence, remember the correct answer for this is ferrosoferric oxide. Fe, ferroso means ferro, ferri is there. So ferrosoferric oxide we call it as. Answer for this question is D. Very simple question and important question. Up to IIT advanced level also this question was asked. Remember, that is on Hall-Herald process. This is a process called as Hall-Herald process. In the metallurgy of aluminium, when the fused mixture is electrolyzed, the overall reaction taking place is. Remember, overall reaction taking place is, so Al2O3 plus carbon give rise to Al plus 3CO2. Remember, in such question, memory is important. And if you remember these things by practicing these in the theory exam only, definitely you can solve this question very easily within a very short time, remember. So answer for this question is C, 3C, Al plus 3CO2. Then, third question we'll see. Third question, which of the following chemicals does not liberate hydrogen gas on reaction with aluminium metal? So aluminium metal is amphoteric in nature, right? Amphoteric means it will react with both acid as well as base to liberate hydrogen gas. So hence dilute H2SO4 it can liberate, NaOH also it can liberate, HCl also it can liberate. But one thing remember, concentrated HNO3 it cannot liberate. The reason for that is aluminium forms passive means very less reactive, passive oxide layer of Al2O3 on its surface. So HNO3 is very strong oxidizing agent. Because of that reason, what happens is, instead of liberating hydrogen gas with aluminium, it will react with the aluminium and form a passive oxide layer of Al2O3. So because of that, it does not liberate the hydrogen gas. Now, decomposition of H2O2 can be prevented by adding, very simple, very important question, remember, it is prevented by adding urea. If you read the textbook, you will definitely you can tell this particular answer. So it is given very clearly, urea which is used to prevent the decomposition of H2O2. Generally what happens is, H2O2 when it undergo decomposition to form H2 and oxygen gas very easily, directly it will form immediately. Hence remember, to stop that you have to add urea. Then carbon monoxide form volatile complex with. So remember, carbon monoxide and these metals, in which process you will come across? Yes, Mohn's process. Correct? So Mohn's process. So hence remember, Mohn's process, in which this nickel and carbon monoxide to form NiCO4 complex. This was volatile complex. Hence the answer for this question is nickel. Which of the following is not a mineral of iron? Remember, limonite is a mineral of iron. So Fe2O3, 2H2O. Magnetite is a mineral of iron. Here only I have written. And carnallite is, remember, formula is KCl MgCl2 6S2O. So it is not having any iron. So hematite is Fe2O3. So the answer for this question is C. Such type of minerals and ore composition they can ask in the exam. So you have to read that. Then So seventh one, sodium cyanide is added as a depressant in the fruit flotation process when ore contains a mixture of ZnS and PbS. This is because, now ZnS and when PbS is present, remember out of ZnS and PbS, depressant NaCN will react with only ZnS, forming, remember, so Na2 zinc CN 4 times complex. Sodium tetracyanide zincate complex is going to form. Because of that reason, so always remember this particular point is that ZnS with NaCN always form this particular complex. So in this case, hence the answer for this question is, this is water soluble. Remember that this is water soluble. So ZnS forms soluble complex while PbS forms froth is the correct answer for B. This particular question, B is the correct answer. So ZnCN twice get precipitated without any effect on PbS is wrong. See, ZnCN twice, it is not forming. ZnTNCN twice get precipitated. See, without any effect on PbS, the statement is correct. But instead of ZnCN twice, this complex should be written here. That is the only mistake. So answer is B. Horn silver is, once it was asked, horn silver is known as AgCl. Idanna gottirbekashte, you have to know this. There is no other way. So there is no other way to remember this. So horn silver is AgCl. So AgCl means halide ore is the answer here. The ore that is concentrated by froth flotation. So remember, froth flotation concentrated only for sulfide ore. Correct? Only for sulfide ore. Sulfide ore is which one? Zincite is ZnO. Cinnabar is HgS sulfide ore. Malachite is CuCO3 and CuOH twice. And bauxite is Al2O3 XH2O. Which means, which is the correct answer in this case? Yes. Cinnabar is the correct answer. So, ninth one. Tenth one. H2 and H2O2 resembles in. You'll see H2 and H2O2 resembles in what? Whether bond angle? No. Because oxygen, water is having structure like this, H2O2 having structure like this, open book like structure will tell. So bond angles are not same, structure definitely different. Oxidation state of the oxygen, we know that this is here oxygen minus 2, here it is minus 1. That is also different. But hybridization is sp3. Hybridization is same for these, resembles in hybridization. So these are the 10 questions which I have discussed from previous year papers. These are the only 10 questions are not enough definitely. You have to go through some more questions from the books, reference books. You have to practice this. Then only you will be ready for the facing that Comet K exam. So all the best. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.